my beans. I am getting ready to soak my beans so that I could cook some red beans and rice, or we call it rice and beans. Okay, we put some rice and beans. You gotta make sure your beans is clean. This is just some pinto beans. Normally we use the kidney beans, but I'm using the pinto beans because that's what's in the cupboard right now, in the cabinet, in my little food pantry. So this is the first step, is to soak your beans. You can soak it overnight, or you could just let it cook slowly. The longer you soak it, the less time you take cooking it. And I have this pressure cooker here, so I'm gonna pressure cook it, okay, so that I can have my beans ready. I don't use the canned beans because it's a different taste with the canned beans. Okay. And now the beans. I'm going to pressure cook the beans. I don't need to put any seasoning in it because I don't want any seasoning in my beans until later. Okay. Okay, pressure. Do custom. Just 30 minutes at a time for now. I am going to soak my rice, wash my rice to get most of the starch out. Gonna cook like 2 cups of rice for the rice and beans. That's the first wash. Another wash. Then after that, I'm going to add the beans in there. Beans is soft already, the bean juice, and a little bit of beans. And we're going to add coconut powder. Use coconut milk. If you don't like the coconut stuff, you can just cook it with just water and some oil for your red beans and rice, for your rice and beans. And add a little salt. And you just let it cook slow on the stovetop. I'll use about 3 pot spoons of beans, and I'm going to get some of the juice, the bean juice. Okay, that's like enough water already. This is why you don't need a lot of maybe too much beans, but if you like a lot of beans in your rice and beans, because that rice is going to swell up, you might want to add a little bit more rice. Some salt. I am using my Tony's according to your taste. And a coconut powder. Flavor. I'm going to add a little bit of butter. And I'm going to add some coconut powder in here. And mix it up. Milky look. So what I ended up with is like 3 cups of rice and 3 spoons of beans and some bean juice. And then you're gonna set it on the stove to simmer on low fire. And I'm going to close. And let it cook. And then I'll show you guys the final results. See, the water is draining down. I use a fork to kind of stir it. Then I look like I need to add a little bit of water. Instead of water, I'm going to add bean juice in there. If you want it to be more coconutty, you can still add a pack of coconut powder in here. Give it some more coconut flavor. I which I will do so you guys can see. You could add more coconut powder. And then you mix it up so that it gives it more coconut flavor. I like the coconut flavor. You could use a spoon if you want to, but I like using the fork. Carefully spread it throughout each grain. And then this is going to soak. And what you can do with this also is, this is a stovetop version. You could take this half-cooked rice and beans, and you could put it in a container, which I will, so you can see. Put it in the oven so the oven can finish soaking it for you. That way you don't lose your rice at the bottom of the pot. I'll put it in a container and put it in the oven so the oven can finish cooking it. Okay, I am getting my oven warmed up. It'll warm up in about 7 minutes. And I'm going to bake this at 350 degrees and then cover it with a foil. So I'm going to take it and put it in this baking dish. See the bottom how it sticks. So I'm trying to not waste a lot of rice. I usually add like an extra topping of my Tony's. I don't want my rice and beans to be bland. That way I could eat my rice and beans without any meat. So, but if you're on a low sodium, low salt diet, don't put all that salt in there. Your butter is enough. Like I said, it's according to your taste bud, but flavor it so that someone else can also eat it. Now I'm going to cover this with some foil. And this is what the pot looked like at the bottom. Bun rice. Going to just like how you would do a lasagna, just cover it up so that the steam can stay inside the dish. And then we're going to put this inside the oven. Perfect rice and beans, Belizean style. Okay, this extra beans that's left over, I am going to put it in a Ziploc bag for later use, you know? So I'm just gonna dip it and put it in this bag. Put it in the freezer, Ziploc the extra beans for later use.